Yes.
I got it.
Okay. What is the subject of your lecture?
My subject is to create artistry through understanding technique. So I try to bind the link between the technical knowledge and actually the artistic expression and the qualities, which is also judged and assessed by the audience and the judges. So it's going to be exciting. And I have some few surprises too.
I'm sure it will be exciting. We are looking forward to see it. Thank you very much.
Yeah. I want to communicate to her, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here, and she feels it all the way. I don't do that through a sensation of connecting to her. I do it through a sensation of connecting to me. That means my biggest goal is my arm related to my sensor, so my sensor can speak through that relationship to gravity. My sensor weight, I enjoy this standing foot, I'm connecting to the hand, I'm not trying to achieve something out here. And that's the first mistake we do, because we feel it through the hand. How many of you, hands up, have felt a heavy partner? You don't dare, it's like, shit. No, no, you're fine. Only boys. It's funny. How many girls have felt an overactive man leading them? It's all right. You all feel that, of course, because it's like a circle with no end. Boy is overcompensating. He wants to help. He's a nice guy sometimes. He overhelps. She becomes a victim. She doesn't know where she is because she's being pushed away from where she should feel herself. So it's all about my own relationship to myself and then respecting the middle part. And the middle is not static. The middle is a dynamic point between two people. So when I lead, maybe she gets closer. Of course, then my arm gets closer. I'm relating to where the hell is she? Okay, she's here, I'm here, and then we go. So that's the point. One couple who does this tremendously well is Timur and Nina. Give them a big hand. So what we can say very strongly is that this couple has a tremendous relationship through weight. We can see they use each other, they can see they use themselves, and it's interactive. Sometimes they use it even too much, but that's another story. They're great at it, because it's better to make that chance than not even trying. You understand the difference? It's much easier the other way. So can you please show me, very slowly, to just mark it through. From where was it? Yes. And a little bit more. We do the old version. Da. And stop. Nice. Okay. You did it too good already. It was not marking too. Actually, what you notice is that there's some kind of organic relationship, that they move in harmony with each other. It's not put on as a production on the outside for the top line, but actually, can you do it, please? I'm not good. You do it. Slow down, and you go. And I'm very interested in the recovery after this. Boom. And then you bring her back, so you can see he nearly overbalances her back to him, and then she turns again, it goes away from each other, and then they recover again. So you have like three or four times changing of weight. The easy solution would be, if I'm a girl, so I'm here, I don't know, would be just to come up and settle. That's safe. Yes, we all know that. So what we do is it comes through, it meets, it goes, whatever, boom, I don't know, boom, boom. Yeah, so it feels powerful from within themselves, and you push yourself, and hopefully you don't push each other. That means the challenge is not with the man or the girl, it's within myself. So they constantly try to work center weight and top of spine against each other in order to create counterweight inside themselves. Yes, need it like that. And then, zoom. That's difficult stuff, guys. That's it. That's the stuff. Thank you. How do we recognize it? We feel it. It's a physical feeling. When you sit there and you watch closely, you feel the energy. If you look on a video, it's not the same. It's completely taken out kinetic energy. So there on a video, you would look at the style. You would look at the two-dimensional version of Timo Nina. When you see them in reality and you sit there, or you people are judging, or they are physically there, we are being moved physically. You know, it feels kinetic energy is vibration through that. So if we make the safe one and it's all wriggly, wriggly, we go, yeah, I don't feel it. You know, it's not there. Yeah, I think it's a huge quality, and it's something that takes years to perfect. And how do we do it? We find it through our own weight. Because you could try to copy that at home, and you will feel tremendous stress. Oh, you're heavy. It's too much. It's too much. It's always too much. Because you haven't found the limit. The limit is, let's say, I normally say this example. If I can be a lovely girl, and I dance a normal rumba, and I go crazy on this one. Stop. Now, a few of you would have thought that I would have been in balance. You would have thought, you know, this way. But what I am doing is, I know the edge. I know my edge is here. And I'm kissing it. I'm not passing it. And that's what you constantly do. Then he's complaining. He would not complain now. You know, because I can put power into the next action. If you cross the line, can you help? Yeah. Can you please help me back? So I can, you know, it's passive, it's negative. So sometimes we say overbalance. In my book, in special variations like this one for sure, in basic action, I can create a lot of illusion of overbalance. I wouldn't do this by myself. You know, if I did it with him, I say, I feel I can reach that edge. Let go. Ah, still there. If not, I don't have him. So in a way, am I overbalancing? Not really, but maybe I am. Because by myself, I wouldn't be able to do it. Yes? Make sense? Timo, Nina, can you please show us beautiful rumba from the beginning? And we will all enjoy your kinetic energy through your fantastic coordination. Yeah, you have it.
Another one.
There's water here. Thank you so much, Simon and Nina. Thank you. Lastly, we can create tremendous rhythmical playfulness with our coordination. Our technique, the way we distribute our weight, gives a tool in order to challenge our time, and our choices in time. That means if I'm perfectly coordinated, I create freedom, choice. I feel like this on Monday, I feel like this on Tuesday, but my technique supports me, so I can do it soft, fast, accentuated, strong, inside of my time frame without a problem. It's not set. Too set is rigid. It's like somebody trains something so much and in the end we lose it. It's like it becomes concrete. And you can say you reach a certain level of your dancing and somehow your trainedness is your biggest enemy, because you cannot unlearn the structure you have put best into your body. So to unlearn a certain habit and sense a moment and finding possibilities inside of it, instead of just going like a push button and here we go. Today samba, tomorrow samba, go again, harder, stronger, more. In the end, yes, we reach a certain level, but magic is not happening unless you, in your brain, are able to find artistry. So we say we learn the rules like a professional and we break them as an artist. But you learn them first, so we can break them, yeah? Marius and Christina would like to show you something very nice. Give them a big hand. Our emphasis is on rhythmical play, which I think they show tremendously in samba. And I would like just to go through, you just mark it through, guys, in the beginning. It's from a rock action. And zoom. Boom, chick, boom, chick, boom, chick, boom, zoom, chick, zoom, 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 nice. You can see already, of course, instead I ask all of the couples to try to do it kind of easy. It's difficult not to do it good, yeah? So even though they're just marking it through, you still sense the sensitivity in their body of when they would have liked to do something extra, you know? So you can see the whole coordination is working, the engine is smoothly working inside, but they haven't just turned up the volume, yeah? So turning up the volume is just to put a little bit more emphasis in and maybe challenging time a little bit more in relation to the standing leg. Can you teach me this stuff, Prusada walk?
Merengue, merengue.
But it's not normal merengue, right? You're playing. Yes, a little bit. Let's try. Teach me. Boom. 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 Yes. So there is a, you know, that game having on. They have a game on. TV. And then it goes. And that's the fun. This is what makes it fantastic. Of course, if your brain goes, let's see how far we can get, you're gone. There's no chance. You will just kind of run with the flow. You will be, and how can we see the difference? It's so easy to see the difference. There's a dynamic, complete different activity in the bodies of the couples who have sensed their weight, who felt and challenged to work around it, or the couples who are just decorating on the outside. It looks boring, constant, if you do not sense your weight and push it. Let's try it one more time. Slowly. Push it a little bit harder. Boom, boom, yum, boom, tick, 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 boom, ticking. Stop. Not bad. Yeah? Actually, quite fantastic. So, I just want you to understand the secret. The secret is in preparation. The secret is not in execution. So what you see is not what you get. Lockstep. It's the fool That is funny or interesting, no? It's not the two, two, two. I can kill myself doing that effect, but actually there's nothing. It's just empty. So the more they challenge, the more they enjoy that weight on the foot, the more they prepare the elastic, the more this comes as a release, and then it looks like no problem for me. Show us. Musica. That's okay. I need also to stand good when I watch it. Yes. Ready, guys? I got it. Kimba. We spoke about three different significant qualities which is also being judged in the judging system, and we all think they're separate. I think they're not. I think they're all interacted, they're all intertwined in each other, and therefore if you understand your mechanics and your technique and your weight, you can create tremendous stuff. So guys, remember, where the hell are you? Figure it out, sense it. Enjoy it, explore it, instead of running after the train. Yeah? That will be my message to you. I will tell you, first of all, I'm extremely grateful and happy that in my entire dance life, I had a beautiful wife who danced and made me great. And she was a big gift for me. And as a dance teacher and a trainer, to be able to work with the best, some of the best couples of this institution, is for me a great pleasure. So I would like to thank you guys for being so great. You see, the point is, as a teacher, it is to make my students better than me. That's the point. I have reached a certain level, and when I look at myself dancing 10 years ago, I'm going, okay, it's 10 years ago, I could have done better. But it's time. It develops. They become much better than I ever would have hoped to be if they have the right priorities and they keep exploring, because the difference between a successful, great dancer with a lifetime of improvement is the mindset that makes either people super, super exquisite or just an average. And it doesn't take a championship to tell that. It's not a championship. It's the level of dancing which is produced. And if they keep pushing that, they will have 10 more years of fantastic development. And then I will in the end say, hey, I'm backing off. Yeah. So I have convinced our great three couples that they should dance a little bit together, all of them. Wouldn't that be nice? So this is something special for me, because I would like to join, okay? So we've done a little part of choreography in Cha-Cha. We did it yesterday night. It was fun, we're excited, and we would like to share it with you. Are you okay with that? Just before we finish. Is that exciting? I think so. Again, Asa Sahina, thank you very much for inviting me. I have to remember my steps now. Shit. Give me a second. 2, 3, yes, got it. 3, yes, let's try. Are we ready?
Stokke Brun.